Paul, Addison Rae, Charlie D'Amelio. Hey guys, it's Allie for Hollywood Life with your YouTube influencer roundup, and we're starting with a TikTok breakup. After 2 years of dating, Zoe Laverne and Cody Orlove have called it quits. Cody announced the breakup in a new video on his channel, but said he didn't want to talk about the reasons or create any more drama than there needs to be. However, he did tell fans he didn't see progress in the relationship. Adding to this, Zoe went live on TikTok and revealed to fans that she and Cody broke up because they fell out of love with each other and they weren't happy anymore. Switching gears to Addison Rae, last week Clubhouse members Sebastian Topete and Isaac Presley received backlash for a Smash or Pass video that many thought was disrespectful. Addison Rae was among those discussed in the video, and Bryce Hall took to social media to slam Sebastian. This resulted in Sebastian firing back by releasing private text messages between him and Addison discussing the video. He captured the post, "I don't know why this man is even pressed," when Addison's fine with it. What Addison wasn't fine with was her private messages being made public. She said, "First, I feel like this is private, so I'm not sure why my text messages are being put out on the internet. Second, I hate being involved in drama, so of course I wanted to make sure Seb knew I wasn't mad at anyone. I feel so uncomfortable addressing this because this is so private, but I need to because clearly it's not stopping. I hate having bad blood with anyone, and I don't think anyone should ever post private conversations without the consent of the other person." And let's stick with Addison, because some of her old liked comments are resurfacing, and some indicate some shade towards Charlie. Well, Dixie caught wind of the drama and subtweeted the jealousy, "Oh my God, and Charlie deserves better." Addison cleared the situation in a long statement that said, "Yes, I did like comments saying she deserves the hype and why is Charlie verified and you aren't in November. I didn't know her and I hadn't met her." She continued, "I've loved and supported Charlie since the day I met her. I think Charlie deserves everything she's done, and I know she genuinely loves doing this and loves her supporters." Meanwhile, Charlie tweeted, "Teehee, I'm chillin'." But okay, let's talk about Charlie's ex now, because some fans allegedly broke into his house. Chase tweeted, "So today I woke up, checked TikTok, and saw that a few girls along with their mother broke into our old house and also took my clothes. This is beyond effing weird. How do people think this shit's okay?" Upon seeing Huddy's disapproval, the women in the videos apologized for entering the house and claimed they didn't steal anything and were allegedly let in by a caretaker. At the time of this recording, it's unclear how truthful they're being or if Hype House will take further legal action. And finally, let's talk about Jake Paul, who went viral over the weekend after he was fake arrested. At this point, Jake's fans are immune to these cop arrested me pranks. The only major difference this time is that his friends decided to set him up to get back at him for the multiple pranks he's done on them. They're also taking advantage of Jake's emotional state, since he was just charged for criminal trespassing and illegal assembly after he was spotted next to looters in Scottsdale, Arizona. Jake was visibly upset with the prank considering his current situation. However, he wasn't upset enough to not post the video, which many consider to be tone deaf, since there are real people with real fears of what police will do to them. But all right guys, hit the sub, like, and bell button. Follow me on social media at Allie Stagnita and stick with us for all the latest.